Hey guys. Guess I'm gonna have to do this again. I tried recording and my recording kind of shut off on me. Alright, so you're gonna need your Psycho Paint and you're gonna need Silk Pig Brown, Silk Pig Black, and Silk Pig Flesh. I already mixed some up, but I'm going to mix it again just to show you. This is gonna be a very thin layer, so you have control over the strokes. You're also going to need some matting powder. So this is technically like our last layer of paint. Our next layer is going to be sealing and matting. And I plan to get that done before I go on vacation for Christmas so you guys can have your babies done by Christmas. All right, let's start with some brown. It's going to be a very pigmented layer also. Now, right now, like the only thing that needs to be wiped down on your baby would probably be the forehead. Because after this, we're going to give it a decent bath and try to get all the stuff we can off of it before we seal. Now, my baby's gonna have darker hair, so I'm using darker colors. Now, if your baby's gonna have lighter hair, obviously you're gonna have to make colors that match the hair color. I'll grab a little bit of black. The black kind of takes out the orangey tint. It turns it more into a natural tone of hair. Let's go ahead and thin it. It's going to be like a 50-50 mix. Now you always want to try to make sure that there is more silicone than there is pigment and all this other stuff because you want it to cure nicely. You are riding a fine line when you're mixing all the additives to this. I say this because I have painted eyebrows and they have come off before. Grab just a touch of the flesh. And the reason we add flesh is because It makes the pigment not translucent anymore. It gives it more of a color. It gives it more vibrance. It's not so pigmented. When you add a white or a flesh color or something, I chose flesh color because I don't want to use white, because white would make it turn it more into a gray tone. I mean, we are literally working with drops at a time. Is my napkin. I'm gonna wipe the edges because we're really gonna be using the edges more than anything to make our lines. And we want to make sure that we're pulling silicone that is cured, like that will cure. So we're gonna be using this brush today, the black one. You're gonna take you're gonna take your matting powder and a little brush. We're gonna take a little bit and put it on the eyebrows. Not a whole lot, just enough. Now, this is the easiest way to do this. It just helps make the streaks more controlled. Turn on my light a little brighter. I need to find a better angle for all this here. Sorry, guys. Guess I have to work around it. Alright. So when you go to get your paint, you're gonna dip it in, and you're gonna wipe most of it off. Alright. We're just gonna start from here. Little streaks. This is a very hard angle for me. So far, you probably barely see anything. Now that you got that side going, we're gonna work in this area, and I'm gonna make a line that pretty much guides me. Looks a little goofy right now. But we're gonna build them. Now I start going the opposite direction. In an upward slant. I always like to make like little straggler hairs. It's just about taking your time. You know, and sometimes less is more. So we're gonna go over here and do the same thing we just did. Too dark right there. Sorry. My kids, they just got back. Sorry. Mom's a little early. Alright, so that is how we do eyebrows. Probably have a hard time seeing it, but they are there. Alright guys, you have a good day, and I'm going to go ahead and make the matting video and sealing video first and right after this cures.